We're sat in the middle of the countryside, farms all over the place, so we try and source absolutely everything that we can that's feasibly possible within the immediate area and certainly within the sort of four or five counties of the southwest. We've got the vegetable garden and we try and we work closely with the gardener, so he's planting the right stuff at the right time of year so that we can use what we've got. It's certainly a good way of supplementing the menu, and it's a good story to have for the guests as well. They can see what we're growing. Also behind there that you probably can't see, we've got a big polytunnel, so we're growing all the micro herbs for garnishing and for salads and stuff, but also we grow and sort of bring on a lot of the flowers. A good old-fashioned butcher that does everything in-house themselves, it's quite easy to work with because, you know, he's going to deliver here 6 days a week if I need him to. So we can get things in as and when he gets them fresh, we get them fresh, and then we can work the menu from that. Taken bits from all the places I've worked and different management styles from all the chefs that I've worked for and sort of made my own management style. You know, we don't want it to be too strict, we don't want it to be too relaxed. We want to certainly encourage the team to be creative. The whole menu, I would never say is my menu, it's everybody. They've got an idea, then we buy them the ingredients, they put a dish on the plate, we take it, we critique it, we then develop it into a lunch menu, and then we push it forward into a dinner menu or an a la carte menu. And then they have a real sort of feel of ownership about it, and I think that way, with sort of 10, 11 guys in the kitchen doing, you know, long days, we don't get too annoyed with each other at the end of the day because everyone's having their own input and they've all got a bit more ownership and a bit more enthusiasm about it. The beef dish we're going to cook is a slow braised beef cheek with wild garlic cream potatoes and a few sauteed morels. It's a lesser known cut and a lesser used cut of beef that braises really, really well and really comes out really rich. So just a simple braise, some mirepoix, some red wine, some veal stock. And again, we're going to braise that for about 10 hours, really slow. Cooking juice will then become the rich red wine sauce. And we're going to simply serve it with wild garlic mash. We've got a nice mashed potato. We're going to put a spoonful of wild garlic puree in there. We're also going to put a pesto made from wild garlic in there as well. And then just a few sauteed morels and a nice rich beef cheek and a nice rich red wine sauce on top. I think with cuts like that, the longer and slower, the better. I think you probably can braise one in 4 hours or 5 hours, but I think by lowering the temperature and increasing the time, you just end up with a much better product. And that whole time that it's in the oven, that sauce, that cooking juice is developing, it's pulling all the flavor from the beef, and you end up with just a sauce that you can't replicate any other way. It is purely down from the braising, and from the mirepoix and from all the flavours coming out of the beef and into the sauce. I think using the cheek, not an expensive cut, you know, it's good for a restaurant to use it, and you know, we can still get value out of it by putting our skill and time into it and producing a good final dish. But I mean, you can cook with beef fillet at whatever it costs per kilo, and it's, you know, you can do that at home, it's not difficult. Again, this just, although the cut of meat is a little bit cheaper, we're adding the value to it with the skill and the experience of the kitchen and producing a dish that's still worth the money that we're charging.